Welcome all the students. Now we will discuss 12th module for the program first year BSc Agriculture Honors for the subject Agricultural Engineering for second semester of course code Engineering 1-1, and title of the course is Soil and Water Conservation Engineering. The name of the module is Runoff, its definition and types. I am Mr. Vinod Atkari, Assistant Professor, Don Bosco College of Agriculture, Sulkorna, KP, Goa. The outline of this module is Runoff, its definition, runoff cycle and types of runoff. At the end of this module, we all are able to learn about the definition of the runoff, the different cycles of runoff and different types of runoff. So, what is the relation between the rainfall and runoff? Rainfall is the primary source of water for runoff generation. Without rainfall, the runoff will not be generated. So, the runoff means what? It is defined as that portion of rainfall as well as any other flow which makes its way towards the river, streams or oceans, etc. Since runoff is through the channel, streams or rivers, therefore sometimes it is also called as channel flow. Runoff is also called as channel flow. Next is the interception. In common course of rainfall occurrence over land surface, a part of the rainfall is lost due to the vegetations or buildings or any objects. Before that rainfall coming to the ground surface, some losses are there. That losses are called as the interception or interception losses. Next is the depression storage. Some part of the rainfall is stored in surface depressions or pits, small pits are known as depression storage. That can be infiltrated into the ground or it can be evaporated. Overland flow, when all losses, that is interception, depression storage, infiltration, evaporation are satisfied, then excess rainfall moves over the land surface and that runoff will reaches to the smaller rills known as overland flow. There are different four stages of runoff cycle. We will see this stages one by one. Stage 1, this refers to end of dry period and beginning of intense and isolated storm. Like it is shown in this figure, the water is very less in the stream because it is the end of dry period and the rainy season will just start. At this stage, all surface and channel storage gets depleted except in reservoir some water is remaining. Under this condition, the source of stream flow is only the groundwater flow and the groundwater table is also lowered due to the losses. The flow decreases with time. Next stage. In this stage, after beginning of rainfall and before the saturation of the interception and depression storage, here the water table gets started recharging due to the precipitation, and the water available in the stream is also more here. In this condition, whatever precipitation takes place falls directly on the land surface or on the stream surface, that is known as channel precipitation. Third stage, this stage refers to the condition of end of isolated intense storm. After long period of continuous storm, all losses are satisfied, that is interception, depression, storage, all losses are satisfied, means no loss due to these factors. Infiltration rate is also reduced to the minimum because all the pores in the soil are saturated due to the rainfall. Overland flow is maximum here because losses are minimum. As shown in this diagram, all these depression storage losses and interception losses are saturated here. Next is the fourth stage. This is the stage indicating after the end of rainfall. In this stage, the rainfall causes overland flow, base flow and development of channel storage. A large amount of water is lost from soil storage, interception and depression storage due to the evaporation. Stored water in surface depression also starts to percolate down to and meets to the water table. Here infiltration is there, then evaporation is also there because it is the end of rainy season. Then there are different types of runoff, three types: surface runoff, subsurface runoff and base flow. We will discuss all these types in details here. Surface runoff means the whatever the water flowing over the ground surface, it is called as surface runoff in short. It occurs when all the losses, that is percolation, depression storage are satisfied, then only water will flow over the ground surface. Second one is the subsurface runoff. Means that part which the water which enters into the soil crust and then it flows laterally without meeting to the water table, that is called as subsurface runoff. This subsurface runoff is also called as interflow. Then third is the base flow. It is also called as delayed flow. It is defined as that part of rainfall which after falling on the ground surface, infiltrates into the soil and meets to the water table, and it flows to the streams and oceans. The movement of water in this type of runoff is very slow. That's why it is called as delayed flow. The movement of water is very, very slow. That's why it is called as delayed flow. It takes long time or years to join the rivers or streams. It is also known as groundwater flow. And finally, the total runoff means the summation of all these, that is surface runoff, subsurface runoff plus base flow. These are the references. Thank you.